Hello everyone and welcome back to Just Finish Coding. This is part 2 of the Dodge the Block series which you're going to be making on Pygame, so let's get coding.
Just finished coding.
Now quick interjection here, if you've not watched part 1 of this series, please watch it before you come here because we're picking up from where we left off. And for this video to make sense, you need to have watched the previous one. I'll leave a card for you right here. Please watch the video and then come right back. If you're still here, I'm going to assume that you've watched part 1, in which case you should be able to move your mouse around and it's a fairly simple program you have right now. In this video, I'll be limiting the movement of the paddle in either side of the screen and we'll also be getting into the block spawning. So let's get right into it. I'm first going to be dealing with the blocks and I have a list right here and I'm going to copy and paste that. And as you can see, we have 4 elements in that list. I've called it XList. And these 4 numbers are going to be the X positions of the 4 different blocks that we could spawn. So 80 is going to be on the left, 220, then 370, and finally 520. And all these numbers are, you know, I've made sure that the block stays on screen and they are pretty much the best numbers that you can use. So once you have this list typed out, what you can do is create your block class. And our block class is going to be really similar to our paddle class. So I'm going to copy and paste most of it. I will be making a lot of changes, obviously, but copy and pasting will make it a bit faster. So I'll call this class block. And once again, we're going to inherit from p.sprite.sprite. And all this is going to be the same. But here, I'm also going to have another parameter called speed, okay? And I'm going to set the self.y to 0. And before I move on, let me edit the self.y in the paddle. And that is going to be set to not 300, but 400, which is what I'm going to be using in the game. So now let's come back to the block. And the speed is going to be set to speed. So self.speed is speed. And the reason I'm doing this is because the game gets progressively faster over time and we'll have one variable called block speed which keeps getting faster each and every time the player, you know, dodges a block. And that speed is going to be what is passed down to each block object when they're being spawned. Don't worry too much about it now, you'll get it within the next few videos. So the image is obviously different and the image that we will be using is going to be block.png. So I'm going to type in block.png and you can see that it's obviously pretty gigantic if we open up the image. So it's too huge, it's 378 and 167 as the width and height, so we will have to rescale it. And I'm just going to simply do it as 120, 60, and this is just simple yet it works so effectively. So 120, 60. And there we go, we get the rectangle and that is all the changes we need to make here within the init method. So now let me get into the update method and this is where things start to get a little bit interesting. So def update and I'm actually just going to type this out because I have to delete the args otherwise. So let's type that. There we go. And within this update method, we just want the block to fall down. So we'll first check its y position. So if self.y is less than the height, and you can just type that in caps letters. And if this is the case, then it means that the block hasn't touched the bottom. Because remember, in Pygame, the top left is what is 0, 0, and we keep, you know, increasing the y position as we move down. So here, all I will be doing is saying self.y plus is equal to self.speed. And I will be just going to that particular position and I'll be using the center of my rectangle to go to that position. And I know I haven't mentioned this, although I use this command in the paddle, and the rect essentially has many points. There's top left, there's top middle, I believe, top right, and then there's mid left, middle or center, and center right, and so on. So each of those 9 coordinates has a distinct name. And center is just one of those 9 coordinates. Maybe it's center up. I'm not entirely sure what the middle coordinate is, but all of them have different names that we can use. And we can just set one of those coordinates to go to something, and that's going to move the entire rect. And that's the way we move sprites. You can't really move just one particular, like the image of a sprite. You need to move the entire rect, and that is why these rect commands are extremely useful. So once you have that, anyway, let's continue. So plus is equal to self.speed, and here I'll be saying self.rect.center is equal to, here I'll put in a tuple, self.x, comma, round of self.y, because our self.speed could be something that isn't an integer, and it's important we round it off so that we don't get any deprecation warnings. As of now, Pygame does allow you to do that, by the way, but they might just remove that feature anytime. So, I mean, there's no harm in being careful. So if this is not the case, then it means that, well, the sprite has hit the ground. And in that case, it means we have to delete that sprite. And for deleting that sprite, it's pretty simple. We'll first say self.kill. And what this command is going to do is it's going to go through every single group that we've created. And it's going to check if the sprite is in that particular group. And if it is in that particular group, then it's going to remove it from that group. And this command alone is not going to be enough, because we will be needing another command to delete this as well. If we don't delete this particular sprite, then it's just going to occupy space in our memory, which is going to be a pain, because as we have more and more sprites, it's going to be more and more memory, and it's going to be a complete disaster. So after this, all you have to type in is del self, and this is going to remove it from the memory. And this is going to make your code way more efficient, and it's extremely important that you add this. Okay, so now I'm going to add in one more method, and that is going to be called def delete. And this is going to be extremely useful at the end when the player has died and the block has hit him, and the one block is, you know, going to detect collision, and it's important to make sure that all our blocks delete and not just that one. So within delete, we'll just type in self.kill and del self. The same thing as what happens when we fall down, but we'll also be having all these blocks within a list so that we can loop through that list and then delete the blocks. So I'll just type that in for now. There we go. So after this, now you can scroll down. And in addition to your X list, you can add in another list called blocks and just have that as an empty list for now. But here, right after this, you can you can type in your first function. And this function is going to be called spawn blocks. And I'm just typing this in as a function because we'll be using it in multiple spaces. So it's pretty useful for us. So def spawn blocks. And within this, I'll be having a fairly simple function. So I'll have I as a local variable. So for I in range, I'm going to do 4 because we'll need 4 different blocks. And each and every time we just have to create a new block object and add it to a group. And you have to remember we don't have a group yet, so I'm going to create it first. So now I'll say block group. That was very bad typing. Block group is equal to p.sprite.group. And once you've created that, you can scroll up and you can just say block is equal to block. And here we have a couple of parameters that we need to type in. And we have the x parameter and the speed. As of now, I'm not going to worry about the speed. Just type in, three or something for the speed. But for the x position, we will need to use this list which we have here. And the I variable is going to help us there. And we can just say x list and brackets, square brackets, open I. So the first index of the x list is going to be the x coordinate of the block. And now, like I said, we need to make sure that the block is added. So we can just say block group dot add and just say block within that. And I'm also going to do one more line of code, and I'm going to append this to the blocks list, because in the end, this list is going to be really useful to us. So blocks dot append, and we just need to append block to it. There we go. That's all we need. And now we can just scroll down, and here we can say like paddle group dot draw. And paddle group dot update, we can just say block group dot update and block group dot draw here as well. So very simple, and this is going to be all we need. And you probably know that we haven't called in our function just as yet. So I'll be just calling in spawn blocks right here. And what you can do is have an if then. So if we can now detect the length of that particular group. We can also use the length of blocks, but I'm just going to use the length of the group because it's a pretty useful command to know. So you can just type in length of block group dot sprites, okay? And here we'll get the number of sprites that is that are within this block group. And if the length is equal to zero, is equal zero, then we can spawn our blocks. So oopsie, I didn't mean to do that at all. Then we can just spawn blocks. There we go. That's it we need to do. And this is automatically going to spawn the blocks when they destroy themselves. So now that's all I'm going to do, and I'm going to run the program. I'm not entirely sure if I made any errors, but this should be working. There you go. You can see that our blocks slowly fall from the top, and this works pretty neatly. Obviously, we don't have the missing block yet, and the program still is kind of basic. So in the next video, we'll be starting to, you know, miss the blocks. And I also forgot to do this, and that was limiting the parallel, which I will be doing in the next video. If you've enjoyed this video, please make sure you leave a like, and also don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.